National Geographic defines colonialism as control by one power over a dependent area or people. It often occurs when one nation subjugates another, conquering its population and exploiting it, often while forcing its own language and cultural values upon its people. Colonialism is presented in different film genders, hence films can help you visualize certain aspects of society, because films can make the exploration of these important issues easy to understand. Cowboy and Aliens is a science western fiction film, and it sends a clear example of one of the main reasons why people conquered lands in the past. The movie helps illustrate the cultural story of white Native American relations. The aliens in the movie came to Earth on a scouting mission to plunder us of gold, which is the same reason why cowboys and western plundered the lands of indigenous American people in the past. This exploitation of gold and natural resources happens around the world with the sole intention of economical gain. Avatar is a science fiction film and is about colonialism. In the film, humans have traveled to another territory and they use imperialism in order to conquer and exploit the Navi land and the mineral under it. Imperialism is presented when humans use high-tech military force in order to gain access to the natural value resources without the care on how many Navy locals they kill in the process. Throughout the years, colonialism has brought violence, wars, and deaths in many countries around the world. War of the Worlds is a science fiction action film. In the film, it's about aliens coming to Earth in order to colonize and exterminate humanity. In this case, humans were natural resources and not the land itself. The movie itself is about invasion, extermination, annihilation, and conquest. In the movie, humans were being colonized by aliens through the means of imperialism with their technology. Kong Skull Island is a Muslim film and it represents colonialism. The island has a unique species of giant gorilla. Kong is the protector of both the Skull Island ecology and the humans living there. He's the anti-colonial protector of the island. Just like any colonial situation, the outsider antagonist uses violence and imperialism to try in killing and exterminate Kong existence. This power over newly found territories and creatures or animals is illustrated by the soldier and antagonist trying to exterminate Kong. Tarzan is an animated adventure film, and it's about conquest and exploitation of resources. Just like any animated film, everything seems so innocent at the beginning of the film. However, in this animated film, we can also see colonialism. The antagonist wants to exploit and capture all the gorillas and sell them for economical power and personal gain. The narrative of the film also helps us to understand Tarzan's innocence as he has grown up away from society's misjudgment and malice. The last film in this subgroup category is District 9. District 9 is a science fiction film. The film illustrates important issues such as immigration, segregation, and discrimination throughout the concentration camps and refugees. The film gives an insight into species hatred, which can also be compared to discrimination and racism. The concentration camp and the film itself represents the eviction and forced removal from one place to another because of being of a certain species. The aliens in this context were refugees on Earth, being mistreated and experimented on by humans in order to gain knowledge on weaponry and new technology. Hand of the Wilder People is an adventure comedy drama. The film articulates a colonial legacy and how post-colonial country is still trying to cope with the consequences of colonialism after British colonized New Zealand. The native Kiwi people are still being discriminated because of their culture or beliefs. This movie gives an insight of post-colonial effects. The sense of identity and belonging to their heritage is illustrated in the film. The history of colonialization is continuous to perpetuate disconnection and trauma in the Maori world. Beast of the Sword and Wild is a drama film and illustrates colonialism, post-colonialism, and environmentalism as a storm hits the southern Louisiana Bayou. This movie blends the harsh reality of an apocalyptic climate change catastrophe such as Katrina hurricane. The bathtub community in this film is separated from the world of industry, consumerism, and modern technology. It is about poverty and political failure to deal with communities on the fringe of society. A Girl Walks Home Alone at Night is an Iranian vampire western horror film. She's a vampire feminine monster and poster a threat to society's order. The film illustrates the expectation on how a woman is expected to behave, especially in Iran where men are still expected to rule over women. Women are often criticized in the context of sexuality or how a woman should dress or behave. As time has progressed, Muslim women are often criticized or marginalized for wearing veils regarding their cultural beliefs. Lemon Tree is an Israeli drama film and is the last film in my subcategory. It is related to the colonial present in relation to the boundary that separates Israel from the occupied Palestinian territories. The main character is an Arab woman, and the film shows us how she is being treated as a woman in a country where machismo and male power is the authority. The movie is about territory and a sense of masculinity and nature of place. The protagonist challenges the Israeli military edict as they plan to cut out the lemon trees. Black Panther is the only film in my third subcategory group, Imagine What If. It is a superhero film, so imagine if Black Panther in countries such as Africa were not colonized in the past. Imagine how a community can develop without having been colonized by external countries. The film addresses neocolonialism and post-colonialism. Wakanda is a community that is united and works together. They hide away from external countries and societies far from corruption and the bad influence of external world. Which one of these films represent my core theme about the present colonialism? Thank you very much.